Hi, I am Wessel Stope, and you are looking at my latest game called The Sapling. It is a short simulation game about life and evolution. The idea is that you build your own plants and animals and see if they can form an ecosystem together. We're now creating our first organism, which is always a plant. This very basic beginner plant is creating just enough energy for one fruit. So let's add that here and we're good to go. This is the backdrop for the game's first scenario. We can select the plant we want to watch. And if we do that, we see that slowly energy is collected to grow fruit. From this fruit, new plants will grow, which will grow their own fruit, etc. If you manage to create a successful species, you unlock new body parts that can help you create more energy. Let's build a more successful plant. You can use leaves to collect more sunlight, which in turn can be used to create more energy. With more than one plant as offspring and no predators, our new plant will grow in number exponentially. This means it will quickly conquer the island and kill the other species, but that's okay for now. Let's look at another scenario. Once you have mastered the basics of an ecosystem with just plants, we get access to a new editor, the animal editor. A basic animal only needs a mouth and some way to move around. This seems okay. As you can see, the game has now calculated how this animal would move. The animal we have created has no eyes or ears, so all it can do is walk around and hope it finds food. In this place it will succeed, because there is plenty of food, but you might want to evolve ears or eyes, as well as some instincts on how to use them, so you can get to your food more efficiently. An alternative play mode is the sandbox. My personal favorite feature of sandbox mode is this button, which turns on random mutations. This means that your newborn plants and animals will have random changes to their bodies, so you can really see natural selection at work. Let's zoom out a bit. As you can hear, the music becomes larger while zooming out. For the music, I use a system that works with a collection of smaller musical pieces that are combined for you on the fly, responding to what's happening on the screen. But that's not the only part of the game that's dynamic. The game is set up in such a way that it can easily be extended by players. Creative players can add new body parts or scenarios by simply adding some Unity asset bundles in the game's folders. Okay, so there you have it, a simulation game about life and evolution. I've always wanted to make one, and this is the result. So I hope you like it.